Now let's talk about the Arnold-Kennedy theorem. As per this theorem, it states that if three plane bodies are in relative motion, then their three ICs must lie in a straight line. Okay, so this is the definition of this theorem. Now, if you look at this arrangement of these three links, 1, 2 and 3, so if you look at the IC of the link 1 and 2, which is 1, 2, and the IC of the link 1 and 3, which is 1, 3, so 1, 2 and 1, 3, they lie in the same line. But the IC of the links 2 and 3 is 2, 3, which is not lying in the same line as 1, 2 and 1, 3. Okay, now this is true as per this configuration, but it is not true as per the Arnold-Kennedy theorem. Why? If you look at this, the velocity of point 3 of this IC, 2, 3, with respect to this link, okay, would be in this direction. You will have V3, which is perpendicular to this link. And if you find out the velocity of the same point with respect to this link, you will have V2. Now the point is same. The point is same, but it has two different velocities, which is not possible. So a single point or a same point cannot have two different velocities. So this configuration is incorrect for the instantaneous center, at least. This means that this instantaneous center will lie on the line which joins 1, 2 and 1, 3 in order to have V2 equal to V3. Then only you can have these two velocities equal. Otherwise, the same point has two different velocities. So this theorem is a valid theorem. That is, for three bodies in motion with respect to each other, their respective ICs must lie in the same straight line. Okay, make a note of this. We'll use this in the next video onwards, where we start talking about the determination of the angular velocities of a link with the help of the instantaneous centers.